Finally, let us discuss in a ROB-based out-of-order execution processor, what really is out-of-order here. So this is our processor pipeline, let's say. This is the fetch stage, there is a decode stage, we issue, then we dispatch, and then we have execution, and then the write of the result, which is the broadcast we have, and then finally the commit. So in this pipeline, if this was an out-of-order processor, keep in mind that not all of these stages are processing the instructions out of order. In fact, from fetch up to issue, we are processing instructions in order. We have to fetch them in the order that they should appear in the program. We then decode them in the correct order, and we fetch them, if you remember, in order. This ensures that any dependencies we figure out here are the dependencies that are compatible with the original program order. Now that we have issued instructions to reservation stations and they're waiting for execution, they're going to execute in the order of data dependencies, not necessarily in program order. So the execution and writing of results are happening out of order. And then, again, commit needs to do instructions in the proper program order, because if you remember, the order of committing is really the order in which we tell the outside world that we are finishing instructions. So this has to happen in order to give the appearance that we are executing instructions in program order. So when we have an out-of-order processor, it really is doing many stages in order, and only the execution and broadcast and things in between are happening out of order. So the dispatching, the execution, the writing of results, everything else is still in order. In contrast, what we would call an in-order processor just does these in order too. But even an out-of-order processor does a lot of things in order.